Here, I am declaring an array of type integer. Integer a 5. Okay, so an array can hold 5 elements of type integer. So as usual, I am using GCC here. So size of integer in GCC is always 4 bytes. So there will be 20 bytes will be reserved for this array A. So I am taking each block of size 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5. So these memory will be stored here. For example, if I am starting its address with 150, then it will be at 54, 158, 162, 166. Okay. So these 5 blocks of each of size 4 byte is reserved in the memory. If I have to store some values here and there are only 3 values to be stored or 4 values to be stored, I can store these values in these blocks. For example, if I have to store some roll number or some value, for example, it's a 10, 20, 15, 17. This is the wastage of memory because this is not being used here. Because I was using this array, I declared it as dynamic, not dynamically, it's statically. So this will be the wastage. And for example, if I had filled 5 values here, this is another case, and that value is for example 19 here, and I have to store 2 more values because I have declared array of 5 integers here. So I cannot store more than 5 integers in this way, because in this way memory has been allocated statically. It cannot be changed, neither it can be reduced nor it can be extended. Okay, so to overcome such type of problems, we shall use the concept of dynamical memory allocation, in which the memory will be executed at the time of the memory will be allocated at the time of execution only. Okay, so there are some functions in which will allocate the memory dynamically. The functions are malloc function. Another function is calloc function, and realloc function. There are 3 functions. Malloc and calloc works almost same, but realloc will reallocate the memory dynamically. We shall see. I will not discuss this calloc here. I will tell what is the syntax to allocate the memory for using this calloc function and malloc function, realloc function, but I will use malloc and realloc here only. We shall allocate memory dynamically using malloc function. We know any function returns some value. Malloc is also a function. what type value it will be returned. So it will return pointer to void. Okay, we shall see here how to use malloc function, whether it's a malloc function, calloc function or realloc function, it will return pointer to void. And we know pointer void pointer or pointer to void is a generic pointer which can be typecasted to any type of data. For example, it can be it can hold float, integer, long, double or anything else. Okay, so dynamic memory allocation using malloc. Malloc function, use of malloc function. So I am writing a program here, main. If there is a pointer, integer pointer p is there. Okay, I am not writing anything, whole program, but I am taking that this is a pointer of type integer, pointer to an integer. So now if I use malloc p equal to, I have to typecast because malloc always returns pointer to void. So I will typecast it, pointer to integer, okay, because it will be holding the address of initial value, or it will be holding the address of or base address, I can say here, malloc here, size of if we don't know about the compiler, what compiler we are using, if we are using Turbo C or GCC, in Turbo C or Turbo C++, it takes 2 bytes, integer takes 2 bytes, but in GCC it takes 4 bytes. So if I am taking only one value, only one integer I am taking, then it will be the size of integer. If I am taking n values, then I have to multiply these n values here. Okay, so similarly, if I use calloc function, how can I write the syntax? Pointer to integer calloc n comma. There will be n blocks of size of integer. Whatever size of integer is there, there will be n blocks will be stored. And n blocks will be allocated. N comma size of integer. This is the syntax of these two functions, malloc and calloc, for integer I'm writing here. Okay, I will allocate a one dimensional array, dynamic array, integer n I, one pointer p is there, okay, in which I will hold the address of this allocated memory, in beginning address, or I can say that base address. Okay, so printf enter the number of values to be stored. I am taking it in n. Okay, now I will allocate memory dynamically. equal to what type of values I am taking? This is type integer. Then I am type casting pointer to integer malloc. N into size of integer. Okay, so this memory has been allocated dynamically, will be allocated dynamically. Now I have to input these values for I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. Enter the value. Percentage P plus I. Okay. P plus I. So in this way, these values will be entered. But when I have to display these values, so I will write here printf the values entered are for I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. Printf or send T P plus I star. So in this way, these values will be printed. In this way, it will be input, and in this way, we shall see whatever has been entered.